All right, so let's continue. Last week we looked at what the definition of what freedom, and we said, what is freedom? The state of being what unrestricted and able to what to move easily. The state of what not being imprisoned or enslaved. Exemption from or liberation from the control of some other person or what or power. Is it there on the screen? Yes. The state of being unrestricted, nothing they hold you, and able to move. You are able to move easily. It means you're free. The state of not being imprisoned or enslaved, exemption or liberation from the control of some other person or power. However, I gave you 3 points last week Sunday, and I discovered that on the third point, I was not elaborate enough. That is, I did not explain enough. We only read one scripture. Who remember that scripture? We read John chapter 8, I think, from verse 30. No? Was that? No. Yes, John chapter 8, verse 3 to 11. Yes, we read that one. And while we were reading that scripture, after we finished reading, we prayed and we closed, have we? And I told myself, I said, look, this particular point, I did not explain what enough. So I need to explain more so that we'll do what, have a better what understanding of it. And I would go back to read that third point again, and that's where we would dwell. This message is centered around that third point. Now read it again. Now, it says, Christ taking our place does not mean we have no what responsibility. We all know that Christ died for us. Abi, he took our place. He died for you and I. We were supposed to die, but he came and died for us. No, so. Yeah. And after he died, it means that what you and I now have what unrestricted access to God. That is one of the benefits of the death and resurrection. Abi, the death, burial, and resurrection of what of Jesus. Unrestricted access to what? To God, the Father. And I've said it many times in this auditorium that God has what? No favorites. Some people feel that God, you know, looks at the color of your skin. Praise the Lord. God does not look at the color of your skin. He does not look at that. Some people feel that some people from a certain race are exempted from some certain things. No. So it means if you are white or if you are from Malaysia, you know, the God of Malaysia is different from the God of Nigeria. There is no such what? There's no such thing. God is God. He's the same yesterday, what? Today and forever. And Jesus died, and it means that we all have what? Unrestricted access to God. So I've said this before and I'll say it again, that you and I are what the variables when it comes to your understanding of who God is, when it comes to who you are or what you know about God, when it comes to blessings, you are the variable. God is what? The constant. God is constant, constant K. But you are what? You are the variable. Now you go determine whether you go move forward or you go there for one place. That is the reason why when you put two people in the same scenario, they react what? Differently. Abi? Two people will not react the same way in the same situation. There are some people you cannot just take their team from there like that too. You cannot just move their head and say, give me your, no, they'll say, oh boy, wait, you safe. There are some people, give me your, yeah, people are different. Let me say, some people will put up a fight. You cannot just take anything from them. Praise the Lord. So you are the what? Variable. God is what? Constant K. He is there. He does not change. He has not changed. Amen. Alright, so Christ taking our place does not mean we have no responsibility and can choose to do whatever pleases us. Now, absolute freedom to make our own rules is what? Is self-destructive. And I've said before, pay attention to this. I've said that you and I have the gift of what? Free will. Human beings are not robots. Praise the Lord. No, God did not write a program and say, okay, telemote, this na so you go, they behave. For morning, every morning when you wake up, you know go brush your teeth. You go chop first before you brush. I don't write the program, I don't put them inside you. You know, computers are like that. Anything you tell a computer to do, it will do what? It will do. If you don't tell it to do anything, it will not do anything, it will just stay like that. So human beings are not what? Computers. You have free will. It is a gift from God. Every human being is free. You can, I've said it before, you can decide to what, get up from here and say, I dey go Port Harcourt. You just enter your keke, you buy fuel. They go where? Anybody go do you anything? Nobody. Free what? Free will. You can just make up one day and say, I don't tire for Bayasa. I don't tire for Yenegua. I won't go live for Kurukuru Sei. I don't wait in. Tire for Yenegua. I won't go stay for where? Kurukuru Sei. Kurukuru Sei. Praise the Lord. We are only going to go to crusade for crusade. Amen. This one, I don't know how what will happen, but very soon she will travel abroad. I don't know how it's going to happen, but she's not going to be here for too long. So we have that gift, but that gift is a very destructive gift if we don't know how to what use it, if we don't know how to manage it. So we have to be able to what? Manage the gift of free will. And it's also important to know that your will is not God's. Your will is yours. Your own will is what? Is yours. Take it down a little. God's will is different from your will. And that is why we must do what? Try to do what? Position our will. The Bible says that we should what? Seek to know what the will of God is. Abi? We should seek to know. So in other words, it is possible for you to be there as a human being and live your life based on what? You live your life entirely based on free will. That's your own will. Do what you like. Eh? And it's dangerous. Freedom is very expensive. Freedom is what? It's very expensive. As children, they are here and they are in their fathers, and sometimes you see some, this is my run time. Every time they send the person message. Okay. You know what's that be? Oh, yeah. Go and stay on your own. Do you know what it means to stay on your own? Should I begin to count it? As a child, you are in your house. Your mommy is what? Feeding you. Your mommy is what? Bathing you. Your mommy is doing what? Washing your uniform. Your mommy is doing what? Paying your school fees. Are you paying house rent? Answer now. Are you paying school fees? When you are sick, who takes care of you? Okay, mommy. Then they now say, go and stay on your own. You have to go and look for house. Yeah? Recently, somebody was telling me that if one bedroom flat where my friend lives, says 500,000 for 1 year. One bedroom flat in Yenagua here. 500,000 for 1 year. One bedroom flat. Before you know, 360 days. Since they don't finish, landlord is on your door again. Hello? Come pay rent. So that freedom you are seeking for, you say, I want to be free. Then they send me message too much. It's not what? It's not cheap. It's not beans. It's not moi moi and what? Gary. That freedom you are looking for. It's not though. And if you are a single man and you are free and you are your own, you know one thing, like when my wife went to stay with her mother. Me, it's very difficult for me to wash plate. I can do any other thing, but I don't have the grace to wash the tea plate. So when you eat finish, that's the reason why me, I told my wife, I said, all this one that you put on, say you want this, you want to cook food and put in the fridge. If you, me, the kind of man, if you cook food and put in the fridge, your food will be there till you come back. I don't have that grace to go to the woman. I'm telling you, that's how I am. Now me be that. I'm not gonna lie. So as a single man, you're in your house, you finish eating, the plate will be there, be? The plate will be doing what? Looking at you like this. And if you don't wash it, it will be there. Somebody say freedom. You now understand that freedom is what? It's not cheap. It's expensive. I want to be free like a bird. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Do we know that song? Spread my wings every night and day. I believe I can fly away. I believe I can soar. To fly, how much is the transport? Say you want to fly from here to Lagos. By bus, is, I don't know, maybe 8,000. If you rush to the airport and say you want to fly now, I'm sure it should be up to 60K. Somebody say freedom. Freedom is what? It's expensive. It is not what? It's not cheap. And Christ has gotten us that freedom. We're free in Him. But we need to understand what freedom means. That is, when I say freedom, I'm talking about freedom in Christ. What it really means. Because technically, we are not free. We are free. Oh. We're free from condemnation. We're free from the guilt. We're free from sin. But we have a responsibility. And that is what I want to make us understand. We talked about it last Sunday. We did not talk about it very well. We want to talk about it very well. What? Today. So we are going to be reading. Now, did you get that point? Please put that number 3 on the screen again. Let's look at it just one more time. Okay, you've not gotten it, but I'll read it to you again. I said, Christ taking our place does not mean we have no responsibility and can choose to do whatever pleases us. Absolute freedom to make our own rules is what? Self-destructive. It's not good. It's dangerous. Now, let's look at the first scripture. We're going to be reading plenty things now. Let's look at John chapter 8, verse 35 and 36. That's where we'll start from. The scriptures are many. John 8, 35. What does it say? We'll read it together. It says what? A slave does not remain in the household forever, but a son does what? Remain forever. How many people are sons here? A slave is not a free person. It means that the person has his time bound. After he's done serving, he will do what? He will go his way. But we are not slaves. We are sons. And because we are sons, we are seated with God. What? In heavenly places. We are seated far above principalities, but we are with Him. So we are not tenants. We are landowners. Look at yourself and say, I'm a landowner. Yes. In fact, not just ordinary land, acres. Me, I have acres in heaven. Acres of what? Acres of land. Some people have two plots. Some people have half of half. Me, I have acres. Praise the Lord. He says, a slave does not remain in the household forever, but a son does remain what? Forever. Next verse. Follow me. It says, therefore, if the Son sets you what? You are really what? You really will be what? Free. Therefore, if the Son sets you free, you really will be what? Free. So the Son, talking about Jesus, has set us free. So it means that what? We're really what? We're free. Let's move on. Follow me. Let's do sharp. Galatians chapter 5 verse 1. Pay attention. We're going somewhere now. Are you free? Yes. I am free. Okay. It says, Christ has liberated us into what? Look now. Look at it. Look at it. Nimbe man, come and sit down here. So that I can be seeing the white of your eyes. Because I don't know. This message might be just for you. Sit down. Aha. It says, Christ has liberated us into freedom. Therefore, stand firm and don't submit again to a yoke of what? Slavery. The yoke there means burden. We're going to talk a little bit about yoke today. It says, Christ has liberated us into freedom. We are free. Therefore, don't what? Last week, when I read a scripture in John 8 about the woman that was caught in adultery, right? Okay. And what did Jesus tell her? He said what? Go. And what? So this is it. He says, therefore, stand firm. Stay one place. Stand firm. And what? Don't submit again. Don't go back to the yoke of what? Of slavery. Praise the Lord. Are you following? Follow me, or we're going somewhere. We're talking about freedom. Now let's read Matthew 11 verse 29. Matthew 11, 29 and 30. It's a very brief message, but it will bless you. Now remember what happened in Galatians 5. What does it say? It says what? Christ has what? Has made us free. Abi? We should not do what? We should not go back. Now let's look at this one. It says, all of you, take up my yoke and learn from me. After he has said that you all of you are free, the word of God is saying all of you are free. Then the same Bible again is telling you that it says what? All of you. We have said you are free, Abi? You are free. Free from condemnation. And then he's now saying again, he says, all of you, take up my yoke and learn from me, because I am what? Gentle and humble in heart. And you will what? Find rest for yourselves. Now, the emphasis here is on the word what? Yoke. All of you, take up my yoke. Now, yoke there means submission. It means all of you what? Submit what? Yourselves. It means to bring under control our passions and desires. Because all of us have passions and all of us have what? Desires. Praise the Lord. Are you listening? Are you following? Children, pay attention. It will bless you. So it says, all of you, take up my submission. Learn of me. Eh? Listen to my instruction. The yoke there is talking about instruction. It's talking about submission. It's talking about letting go of your what? Passions and what? Desires. That's what it means. And learn from me. Because I am gentle and what? And humble in heart. And you will find what? Rest for yourselves. How many of us want rest? If you want rest here, then you have to learn to be what? You have to learn to submit. Most people, they don't want to be under any form of authority. They call themselves freelancers. And what did I say before? To be a freelancer is expensive. And you can end up destroying yourself. It's just like you give a limousine to a five-year-old boy. What will happen to him? Say, see the key, take it, whatever you like, do with it. A limousine is $500,000. You give it to a five-year-old boy. What do you think is going to happen to him? Say, leave him. Leave what? Leave him. Whatever he likes, you should do. The next time you hear that, what? The boy has what? Maybe you go and put the key in the ignition. My daddy has given me limousine. And then maybe before you know, smash the windows or you know, wee inside. And poo-poo, and turn the place to toilet. Call his friends, his other five-year-old friends. They'll carry razor blade and start tearing the leather inside me. Why? Because he doesn't know what the value of what? Of the limousine. A five-year-old boy does not know the value of a limousine, does he? No, absolutely not. It says, for my yoke is easy and my burden is what? The yoke there is talking about submission. It's talking about responsibility. It's talking about letting go. For my instruction is easy and my burden is what? Light. Take my yoke. Go back to the other scripture and get the other verse and give it to me in King James. Let's just look at it there. Because that's the one a lot of us know. So let's read it in the King James. It says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto what? Your souls. Remember what we said. What did we say? I read it again. Christ taking our place does not mean we have what? No responsibility. As Christians, even in the midst of the freedom that we have a part to play. We have things to what to do. Let me borrow mommy's grammar. We have what things to what to do. I said it last week. Freedom in Christ does not mean I dey go ogogoro to drink what? Ogogoro. Say I am free. Christ has made us free. Who the Son of Man has set free is free what? Indeed. And then you begin to move around. Say, where did they go? Say, I go, Ogogoro. We are free indeed. We are what? Free indeed. He has set us free. And they move now. I am what? Where did they go? And they go. The Perama, they play for Dang in Agua. So I go there. Hot pepper soup go there. So they go. Now I go dance small. Now I go my eye then too. My eye too clear. Mommy, my eye small. My eye what? Too clear. I want make my eye dirty small. So I go there for dying in Agua. And then you quote the scripture. You know you can quote scripture to suit anything. Say what? Christ has made me free. Therefore, I am free indeed. I did go there to go get my eye dirty. Freedom. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm free. You can quote the scripture to back up anything you want to. You understand? You take it out of context and say, we are free. The Son of Man has set me free. Hallelujah. But you forget this one. You forget that one. But it says, take my yoke. What? Take my yoke upon you and learn. You know, some people, when they only quote the one that will suit them, they will not quote this one. No? They will not say, this is for all the other. You know, the New Testament is filled with a lot of instructions. God's word is God's instruction on how we should what, conduct ourselves as believers. Don't be so. So some people will just pick out one or two scriptures and say, ah, now this one. This is what the Lord said to me in the night when I was sleeping. He said, I'm free. He has set me what? Free. So therefore, I can be anywhere. His grace is sufficient for me. You don't read this side. We are not, no, the yoke, no. Now only egg yolk I go chop, but this yolk, I know. I'm not interested. I'm not what? Interested in the yoke. I'm free, no yoke. If na yoke, na the boiled one. Praise the Lord. But that's not how we should live. That's not how to do things. Take my yoke upon you. Submit, it means what? Submit yourself to what? To God the instruction. When the Bible says yoke, submit yourself. To what? To godly what? Instruction. So just because you are free and you know that you have this consciousness of freedom in Christ does not mean that you can live what? Anyhow. Absolutely what? Absolutely not. Now let me read something to you before we continue. We'll soon be rounding up. To live freely or to be free in Christ is to live responsibly. To live freely or to be free in Christ is what? To live what? Responsibly. To be responsible. Christ is the example, is our example. We sing that song a lot. Lord, I want to be like Jesus. What? In my heart. Was Christ irresponsible when he was living here on earth? Eh? Answer the question. Was Jesus irresponsible? He was not. So if we as Christians were trying to be like Christ, Abi, that is that not the essence of Christianity? That is the essence that you and I are trying to be, do what? To be like him. Don't be so. Then it means that we must live in conformity to what he says and how he lived, because the life of Christ too is an example for us. Don't be so. Not so. It's an example for us to follow. So if Christ lived responsibly, you and I are meant to do what? Live responsibly. Just because he came to die and make us free and all that does not mean that we should live what? Anyhow, I'm trying to make you understand this thing. Because some people will take this matter out of context and say, Pastor said that we are free, so we go do anyhow. I'm telling you, some people just have that mindset. They just quote that scripture and quote it and leave it like that and do anyhow. I'm free. You are going to the strip club. To the what? The strip. You know what a strip club is? Yeah, they are naked women, half naked people. You are going to say, I'm free, so I can move anywhere. No. To live freely is to live guided by the totality of God's word. To live freely is to what? Live what? Guided by the totality of what? God's word. That is what it means to be free. It means to be responsible. It means living what? Guided by the totality of God's word. Let's look at 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9. We're almost rounding up. 2 Timothy 1 9. That's the scripture, right? What does it say? It says, who hath saved us and called us with an what? Holy what? Calling. So you are saved. You've been set free. But there's a calling on your life. You are not set free to just go like that. They didn't set you free and say, go. Even when Jesus met the woman, he said, go. But there was an instruction. Are we? Yeah. And sin, that's the instruction. He didn't say, go. And go. And continue from where you stop. Hallelujah. Yes. Go and enjoy yourself, woman. And some people will read that scripture and just hear, go. Say, I see I'm going to save me, just tell me, say, ma, go. Ma, waiting. Ma, they go. Nothing they happen. And they go. So that's the problem with a lot of people. They just go. They come to church and then they do what? They go. We will not just come to church and go like that. We will come to church, hear the word of God, and something will change on the inside of us. Hallelujah. You cannot tell me that since you have been coming to this church, something about you has not changed. Even if the change is slow, because we all know that change is a process, but definitely something about you has what is different. No be so. Your status has changed. Abi, no be so. When you came to this church, I know where you are, how you were doing. But now, there's some little bit of maturity on the inside of you. And you were not an undergraduate when you started, Abi. Now you are an undergraduate, Abi. See, level has what? Has changed. Something is changing. So we cannot just come and go like that. We come, then go, then come, then go. So waiting to happen, we just they go, they come. They waiting, they come, they go, then they waiting, they go, they waiting, they come. Say, bros, how far now? This kind of life safe now, wow. Say, now we start the church, now we start the church. We start the church. So how far your life? We just they go, they come, they go. Ah, no. You cannot just be going and coming and coming and be going like that in this church. Your life must move forward. In fact, I want to even tell you that God does not even need your permission for your life to move forward because you are here, like the story of Obededom. Because the presence of God is here. Your life must experience transformation in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah, so your status must change. Your level must change. Your thinking must change. Because your thinking is the most important thing. Once your thought pattern, once your thinking pattern changes, once there's a change in your thinking pattern, your mentality, your life will change. It is possible for somebody to be living in a waterside, but the person does not have a waterside mindset. Have you not seen some people in some area, in your local area, but they live an international life? You're saying you are living in Agodama inside, but there's one person like that, you just know this person. The packaging of that person is not, it does not reflect the environment. Just know that that person is what? Bigger than that environment. And one day that person will leave. Take me back to that scripture. It says, who had saved us and called us with an holy calling, not according to what? Our works. But according to his own what? Purpose and grace, which was given us in what? Christ Jesus before the world what? Began. We have a purpose. Everybody here has a purpose. We do what? We have a purpose. There's a reason why you were born. And it is your responsibility to discover what? That reason. If you're not sure, you can ask the person who made you. Who made you? God made you. What called, what had saved us and called us and called us. There's a calling. There's a calling. Every believer has a calling. I'm not saying that when I say calling now, some people think it's being a pastor. No. That's not it. When you say calling, some people think, oh, church. Start church. Start church. No. You don't have to start church to talk to somebody about Jesus. Do you? No, you don't have to. So we all have a calling. And our primary calling as believers is to what? To win souls. Abi? That is our primary responsibility. So you cannot win souls when there is nothing different about you. In fact, the best message you can ever preach to anybody, is your lifestyle. Praise the Lord. Did you hear me? The best message you can ever preach to anybody is what? Your lifestyle. There's something called no word message. Your mouth is closed. Some things will be happening in your neighborhood. It'll be like, this guy, no. It is your neighbors that will come out to defend you. But some of us, if we go to our neighborhood and we ask and say, this guy, say, that guy, no. It's a very irresponsible person. That girl, no. She don't listen to her mother. Every time she quarrel, her mother they talk one, she they talk 16. No word message is more powerful than talking to somebody. True. Your character is more valuable when it comes to soul winning. Your character, your lifestyle is more valuable than what you say. Your lifestyle is more valuable. People will take you for what they see you do, most especially if you live in a particular area. Say, what type of person is this person? Say, in the thief people things, but in the go church. We know him. Now that church in the go, but in head not correct. They have concluded on your matter. And then when you go to talk to them, they say, not be you. You know, you know. That my rod that time with that two of my rod, you collect two of my rod. My shovel where they lost. Now your house today. Now they can't tell me about it. About Jesus. They will not listen to you. They will make mockery of you. Because your life is the best. Yes, it's the best form of the gospel you can preach. Your lifestyle. Amen. Where are we? Let's continue. So that we can go. Let's look at Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 to 10. Ephesians 2, 8 to 10. Are you blessed? Yes. Follow me, follow me. You will definitely be blessed. Ephesians 2, 8 to 10. It says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is what? The gift of what? God. You are not saved by yourself. You didn't die for yourself. The freedom you are enjoying as a believer, did you give yourself? You didn't. Somebody stood in your place. So that's what the scripture is trying to tell us. It says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, believing in God, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of what? Of God. Verse 9. Let's keep going. Not of works, lest any man should what? Boast. I died for my sins. Can any man say that? I paid for my sins. See the teller here. I pay. I subscribe every year. 1 million.
my own sins. The Siam.
Can anybody say that? Nobody can say. It's free. Jesus did it. So that nobody can come and say, yeah, you see that girl, those people there for down for I can't for that side. Now me die for them. I die for I can't for people. I die. Nobody can say that. Not of works, lest any man should what? Boast. Verse 10. For we are what? His workmanship, created in what? Christ Jesus. Unto what? So the freedom you and I enjoy is for freedom unto what? We are supposed to, we are free in Christ to do what? To do good. Did you get that? Is that to do good, to do good works? Is it not responsibility? Good works. Is it not what is written there? Give it to me in the other, let's see it in the other version. It says, for we are his creation, created in Christ Jesus for what? Good works. Somebody say good works. Good works. Good works signifies responsibility. There's something to do. Good works. Not free to do anyhow. Free. Freedom. For good works. Freedom to help other people. Freedom to make sacrifices for other people. Thank you. Huh? That is what we are called to do. For we are his creation, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared ahead of time. You know, he sees the end from the very beginning. Which God had prepared for ahead of time, so that we should walk in what? In them. Praise the Lord. So we don't forget this. We are created to do what? Good works. Look at your neighbor and say, good works. Look at the next person and say, good works. You people are not looking at yourselves. So look at yourselves and say, good works. Thank you very much. Some people are just, good works. As if your battery is about to die. Receive strength in Jesus' name. That is what Ephesians, shall we? Ephesians 2, 8 to 10. Now let's move on. We have more scriptures to read. We'll read all of them. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 9 to 17. This one is a long one. We'll try and run through it. I'll read them sharp, sharp. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 9. Ephesians 5, 9 to 17. It's a long one, but I'll read sharp, sharp. It says, for the fruit of the light results in goodness and what? Righteousness and what? Truth. For the fruit of the light results in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. Verse 10. Discerning what is pleasing to the Lord. Discerning what is pleasing to the Lord. Verse 11. Don't participate in the what? Fruitless works of darkness. I am free. I am free. We are free. Free. When they see him, I think. Those of you that say that you are free. Who the Son of Man is set free. Is free indeed. See him now. Don't participate what? In the fruitless works of darkness. But instead what? Expose them. Is that not responsibility? It's responsibility. Move on. Verse 12. For it is shameful even to mention what is done by them in what? In secret. Continue. Verse 13. We're going to 17. Everything exposed by the light is made what? Clear. Verse 14. Keep going. For what makes everything clear is light. Therefore it is said, get up, sleeper, and rise up from the dead, and the Messiah will what? Shine on you. God is shining on us in this place. In Jesus' name. Let's keep going. 15. Pay careful attention then to how you walk. Not as unwise people, but as what? And they go down Yenagua. Nothing they happen. I am free. My wife is looking at me. I am what? I'm not free. I'm married. There's a ring around my hand. If I just get up in the morning and tell them, I'm just get up and start wearing my dress, my wife will come and say, boy, where you go now? Where are you there? I'm free, but I'm not free. I'm free, but what? I'm not free. I have a commitment. I have a family. Oh, my beautiful daughter is right there. So he says what? Pay careful attention. Those of you that think that you are free, pay careful attention. Then, what? To her? To how you what? You walk. Not as unwise mumu, foolish people, but as what? Wise. Be wise. Look at your neighbor and say, be wise. Foolishness. Some people talk anything. You read the cure coronavirus. Boil your own drink. I only see wise people in this building. Wise people I am. Wise children. The Bible says that wisdom is what? The principal thing. It says in all you're getting, do what? Get understanding. Get wisdom. Get understanding. Very important. Don't be foolish. Continue. Making the most of the time, because what? The days are what? Are evil. All of us here, we are time bound. Our lives is time bound. So we must make what? Good use of your time. Me, these days, I'm telling you, ask my wife, she'll tell you, it's like 24 hours is not even enough. I'm trying to break new grounds now. There's something I'm trying to learn now. Trying to break new ground. So most of the time I'm in the office, this one is dragging me, that one is dragging me. Before you know, sometimes, even last night, do you know when I slept? I slept around, after I finished what I was doing, prepared the message, do that one, I was working on a song till around 2 a.m. That's when I slept. And I'm 2 a.m., I'm outside my house. I did outside, 2 a.m. 2 a.m., that's when I slept. I'm telling you, Pastor Jordan, Joseph, 2 a.m. Then I slept on the parlor. My wife and baby were in the room. Then 6 o'clock, I don't know. How many hours with that? 2 a.m. to 6 o'clock, how many hours? How many hours with that? 4 hours. That's what I slept. I slept 4 hours yesterday. 4 hours. I'm here. I'm a little fagged out, but I did. But if I not tell you say I sleep 2 o'clock, you'll not believe. Let's continue. 17. Somebody should read this one for me, I beg. Somebody should read this one. Maybe Nebeman should read it. Let me give him the microphone. Or I read it for me.
So don't be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is.
So do not what? Don't be foolish. But remember what I said about free will. I said we all have what? Our own will. This scripture is telling that you have your will. Your will is yours. Your will is not God's will. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is your will, there is the will of God, and then there is the devil's will. Those are the three wills we have. Your own will is there. Your own will is different from the devil's will. You as a person, you have your will. And then there's God's will, which this scripture is saying we should do what? We should but understand what the Lord's what will, what is. Free, but we need what? Understanding. Praise the Lord. Let's continue. That's 17. That's the last one. Let's move on. Sharp. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11 to 17. We have how many scriptures to read? 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow. We'll read them. Because I said I'm going to make sure that I teach this very well. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11 to 17. Okay, let's read it sharp. It says, put on the what? Full armor of God. Free people. But this is another instruction to the free. It says, put on the full armor of God so that you can stand against the tactics. Child, the devil has tactics. Sickness, you know? The devil. When you say tactics, the devil is a military man. He has been to the war. You know, he fought in heaven, so he's a tactic. He knows how to plan. He knows how to get you. But he won't get us in Jesus' name. It says, put on the full armor of God so that you can stand against the tactics of what? The devil. Tactical. Oh, see grammar. Tactics. The devil is crafty, he's sharp. So you have to be sharper. You have to be what? The devil is sharp. You have to be 20 steps ahead of him. And the only way to do that is what? Is to put on the armor. So we are going to look at it. We'll continue. The next verse. Sharp. It says, for our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the world powers of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the what? In the heavens. There was one guy that killed somebody. Many years ago, I was watching that story. And they now asked him, say, why did you kill so and so so person? Do you know what he said? You know his response? Let me tell you his response. He said, voices in my head were telling me to kill him. Voices in my head. Voices what? In my head. So he was sitting there and he was hearing voices. And he said, go and kill that person. Go and kill that person. Go and kill that person. Most of the people you see that commit crime, most of the time, those crimes are what? Premeditated. They sit down. They calculate. They say, come that up. Am I lying? It's premeditated most times. People don't just do things, you know, out of impulse. But especially crime, people sit down, think about it. That is why the Bible says that we should what? Guard our mind. Renew your mind. Because your mind is your powerhouse. That's where everything about your life flows from. If you want to change your life, if you truly want to change your life, I'm talking to everybody here, present here. If you want to change your life, start by changing your mind. It's not to take your money and go to the tailor and pay for clothes. I'm not saying that people should not patronize our sister. Please go and give her your clothes to sew. However, what you need to start to do first is to what? You start from your inside. Some of us like to spend money on makeup and trousers. And I'm not saying looking good is good. I'm not against it. But if you truly want to change your life, it's from your inside. It's from what? It's from your inside. Next verse. This is why you must what? Take up the full armor of God so that you may be what? Able to resist what? In the evil day, and having prepared everything to take what? Your stand. We have a stand. We must prepare. We're free people. How many free people do we have in the house? Wave your hand if you're free here. Wave your hand. I want to see the free people here. Hallelujah. We are all free, but we have a responsibility. Take your what? Your stand. You must take your stand. You are free, but you must take your stand. Let's go to the next verse. Think we're reading up to 17. Stand therefore with the truth. With truth, okay? Like belt around your what? Righteousness like armor on your chest. Continue. Next verse. And your feet sandaled with what? Readiness for the gospel of what? Of peace. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. Next verse. In every situation, take the shield of... Mommy likes to talk about this one a lot. Mommy's a faith preacher. Mommy's a faith woman. Says what? In every situation, take the shield of faith, and with it you will be able to what? Extinguish the flaming arrows of the what? The evil one. The devil likes to fire darts at our hearts. You know? The Indomie don't they finish for your house. Hey, this Indomie don't they finish your child, child, child. Like yesterday, let me use myself as an example. Yesterday, we're in the house, and then and I asked my wife, I said, in the night I was in the office, she now came, ah, what you go chop now? She said, there's bread, I was like, Indomie. She now said, ah, the Indomie, only one remain. Devil just, you know, something just came to my head, hey, only one don't remain. One, nine remain now. You know, the devil has a way of just saying, see, the only one don't remain. And then one day I was sitting with my wife, and I'm recently, two of us, we were just talking. And I asked my wife one question. I said, has God ever left us stranded? We have been here. Has he ever left us stranded? Has God ever left you stranded? Pastor Joe, has God ever left you as in, no, you just day, no hope at all? Absolutely, that kind of thing, no, it's not possible. And the devil likes to play that trick with us. You go there, maybe you won't go back to school. Won't go to school, your transport money will complete. You go trek. You go, there's your school. Now what that thing? You go swim. Go reach there. Don't worry. No, if you're hungry, go cash you. No get money. That's the devil. It will just make you just worry that. It happens. But has God ever left like stranded? Absolutely not. One way or the other. You may not have everything you want to. You understand? Maybe you're looking for maybe 25,000 to go back. Maybe at the end of the day you have maybe 15 or 10 or 20. He never leaves us what? Completely what? Stranded. Say no hope. But the devil will always come. You know? Bah. Indomie won't finish. Bah. Yeah. Eh, you know, say school goes no reason. I think you get 3 children. I want to take this school fees. Yeah, that's the devil. Just makes you worried. But the Bible says what? In every situation, do what? Take the shield of faith. You tell yourself that this God that has started this good work, what? In what? In me. He's more than able to do what? Jehovah Jireh, what? Does not leave anybody. Me, God has never left me stranded. Never. Even when my battery died for Gudama, for road, somebody brought battery for me, I don't know from somewhere, to start my motor. Has never left me stranded. Never. So we must do what? We must take up that shield of what? Of faith. And believe that God that has brought us this far is able to continually do what? Keep us. Praise the Lord. How many of us know that God is capable of keeping us in this place? I want to let you know something in this building, that God will not disappoint you. Amen. Hold on to what? Hold on to Him. He will not forsake you. His word says, I will neither leave you what? Nor forsake you. He will not forsake us in this place. It might be tough, it might be rough, but he will step in on time and make every crooked path what? Straight for us. He will be our what? Bridge over troubled waters. You know the flood, the Nagua flood. Last year, covered the bridge. And the water, the flow. The Bible says that God will what? He will be our bridge over those type of what? Over the situations, over the problems. Let's continue. Last verse. It says, take the helmet of what? Salvation. And the sword of the Spirit, which is what? God's word. Free people, are they here? Are they shouting now? Because this is the land of the free. There's a place called Freetown. It is the capital of where? Senegal. Senegal is a West African country. The capital of their country is what? Freetown. Free what? Freetown. Things are not free there. Yeah, just because, hey, in a Freetown, they go there. See free house. Free mama. Free chicken. My go there now, you discover that your naira has no value there. But the name of the place is what? Freetown. Gift shop. Okay. So you go there and you can pick anything you like and walk out of the place. The name of the place is what? Gift shop. Thank you very much. They will hold you. Let's continue. Let's continue. No time. No time. No time. Please. Forgive me. I said it was going to be brief, but I'm trying because I really want to read all the scriptures. Are you being blessed? Are you being blessed? Should I continue? Okay. 1 Timothy 5 verse 8. More do quick, more do quick. The scripture is plenty. 1 Timothy what? 5 verse 8. 1 Timothy 5, 8. I want to read them. Let's read them together. It says, now if anyone does not provide for his own... Oh my God. I said this one, I must add this one. I must do what? Free people or free. We are free. We are what? Free. We are free people. Hallelujah, I'm free. But look at this one now. It says, now if anyone does not provide for his own relatives and especially for his household, he has what? Denied the faith and is worse than an what? Unbeliever. You have money. You don't want to give it to your family people. That you can put it in bed, Niger. Or you have money. Mommy said, Marata. You have money as a man. You don't want to bring out the money for your children to eat, or you don't want to pay school fees. Yeah, man. Haka go. Don't want to take care of some people, they are very irresponsible. As free people, we have what? A responsibility to make sure that there is what? Food in the house for what? Our children and our wives. And even the Bible says what? Relatives. So not even only yourself. Say your relatives. I like his own relatives and especially his household. He says worse than an unbeliever. So you, as a man, as a woman, in fact, let me even say this. I was saying, I just remembered. I was raised by my mother. Paid my school fees. Paid my house rent. I didn't lack anything when I was in university. I lived like, in fact, when I was going to school sometimes, I was driving in my final year, I was driving a Jeep. And police stopped me one time and told me, say, I told the guy, I'm a student. The guy says a lie. Say, how can a student? He say, you're a lecturer. Policeman, they drag with me. I didn't tell him I'm a student. He didn't believe because of the car I was driving. She didn't say, the father has left them. So therefore, the man, they take care of children. The man, they take care of children. She didn't do that. Sold wrapper to pay school fees. I'm here. So if you're a woman and you're having issues, I'm just saying, and some women, they just feel that responsibility, anything that has to do with children or bringing food is the man's complete responsibility. So if the man is not there, there will be mass hunger in the land. It is a lie. Me, I was raised by a woman. I was raised by what? I was raised by a woman. A woman paid my school fees and bought Christmas clothes for me to wear. I'm telling you the truth. So if as a woman, there is no man, then you have to man up. You have to do what? You don't have to. You don't have any excuse not to be a contributor. You must contribute something. You must do something. When the time is right, children, you must learn to take responsibility, you know, small, small. Free people. Free what? Freedom Assembly. There's a church like that. There's a name. Abi? I never heard that church name before. Freedom what? Freedom Assembly. See ya. Own relatives, especially the household. Food must dey the house. Food must wait in. It is part and parcel of the responsibility. It is part and parcel of what? Freedom. Not because you say I'm free, therefore you carry your money do anyhow. Don't provide for your family. Don't want to pay school, don't want to pay house, don't want to do anything. All you want to do is flex. Where are you when small money enter there? Where are you there? Are they asked us? Go shop shaking there. Gary no day the house. Gary no day. I'm gonna fast. Fast and pray. Fast and what? Pray. Irresponsible. The Bible says you are worse than an evil. Look at it here. So I'm trying to make you understand the responsibilities that come with the freedom that you and I enjoy. Praise the Lord. Let's continue. Are you being blessed? Yes, so. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. So it's a popular one. Hebrews 12, 1 to what? 2. It says, therefore, since we also have such a large cloud of witnesses surrounding us, let us what? Lay aside what? Every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us, and run with endurance the race that what lies before us. Let us lay aside. Free people, but we should do what? We should lay aside. Weight there signifies what? The things that what our desires and passions, the things that try to draw us away from God. We should keep those things what? Aside. So that we can run. Next verse. Let's keep running. Please. Time don't they go. Keeping our eyes on Jesus, the source and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that lay before him endured the cross and despised the shame, and has sat down what? At the right hand of God's what? God's throne. So we should look up to Jesus. If you're having difficulty, you know, living your Christian life, Jesus is the perfect example. So we need to do what? Look up to him. There's a time I preached a message here and said, what? Look up. You remember? Look up. Amen. Two more scriptures. Romans 14, verse 12. You can go ahead at home and just read the scriptures and, you know, take time to meditate on them. It says, so then each of us will give what? An account of himself to who? To the chief priest in his own community. Free people. We are free, oh, but see. I'm free. I'm gonna speak English. So I'm free. You're free. I'm free. You're free. Are you free? You're free? I'm free. Do whatever I like. So then each of us, not as a family, didn't say the family of Joseph shall give, say each of us. It's an individual thing. It's a personal thing. Huh? Is it what? It's a personal thing. At the end of the day, he says, so then each of us will give an account of himself to who? To God. So continue living in the freedom that you say you want to live. So call and say, so the life that I gave you, what did you do with it? One day, somebody will ask us this question. Say, I gave you, maybe let's say, for example, you lived 90 years. Example. I know all of us will live more than 90 years. You live for 100 years. You go to heaven. God not ask you. So, I gave you 100 years. What did you do? I just say, from the age 35 to 75, you were busy flexing, moving up, and aimless movements. That shall not be our portion in Jesus' name. Amen. So we should be conscious of what? Of this one. We should have it at the back of our, not at the back, in front. Because if we have it at the back, we'll forget. Let us have it what? In front of our minds. Not at the back of our minds. No, since when something day for back, you will forget. Yeah. Amen. Let me leave it there. Last scripture. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 from verse 12 to 14. Last scripture. We don't do. I said I go read them, I go read all, and I don't read all. It says, but beyond these, my son, be what? Be warned. There is no end to the making of many books, and much study wearies the body. Continue. Next verse. When all has been heard, the conclusion of the matter is what? Fear God and what? You people are not looking at this thing. Are you seeing it? Read it along with me. Free people. One, two, go. When all is heard, has been heard, the conclusion of the matter is fear God and keep his commands, because this is for all free people. Free people. Fear God. You are free. Fear God. You are free. Keep his commandment. You are free. One day we shall all what? Give account of ourselves to what? To God. Let's read the next verse, which is the last verse. It says, for God will bring every... let's read it all together. All of us. One, two, go. For God will bring every act to judgment, including every hidden thing, whether good or evil. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet.